Hey everyone, welcome to this video where we'll be looking at thermogravimetric analysis, or TGA. This shows the thermal behavior of polymers, or more specifically, how the weight of the polymer changes as a function of temperature. So we'll be looking at the introduction of TGA, the instrument setup, the applications related to polymers, the advantages and disadvantages of TGA, and finally, other complementary techniques that can give you a full view of polymers. In simple terms, thermogravimetric analysis is nothing but the weight loss which is measured as a function of temperature. So with increasing heat, we can find the range of temperature at which the polymer degrades. And with this, we can find out the chemical profile of the polymers as well. So when it comes to the studying of polymers, we can get quite a few important parameters from TGA studies. The first is the degradation temperature of the polymer. We can look at the kinetics of the degradation. We can find out information about the additives that are added, polymer blends, and so on. This helps us make important decisions during the research development and quality control of polymers. The TGA instrument consists of a microbalance with high sensitivity, capable of measuring weight changes in the range of milligrams to micrograms. It is also equipped with a furnace, which is able to provide controlled heating as well as isothermal conditions. The instrument also contains a sample pan on which the sample is placed, and also a reference pan which is used for calibration. Some of the commonly used pans are aluminum, quartz, platinum, ceramic, and other closed lids depending on the temperature that is being used as well as the type of polymer so that it does not react with the pan. The TGA also has a provision for controlled gas delivery where we can choose either oxygen, nitrogen, air, or any other specific gas that is used for control studies. And finally, no system is complete without the software. In this case, the software records the weight, which is in the order of micrograms, as a function of temperature as well as time. The software is also capable of displaying the results in the form of graphs for easy visualization. So the TGA experiment starts out by placing a small quantity of the sample on a platinum pan. This pan is then moved into a furnace where the temperature is controlled at a steady rate. Continuous weight measurements are being read by the software, which then plots the graph of the TGA. So as the temperature increases, we see that the weight of the sample decreases because of degradation. Now let's dive deeper into the uses of TGA and how it helps to understand the behavior of polymers. So the first use is to understand the thermal stability of the polymer. So thermal gravimetry analysis can help to identify the start of degradation of the polymer. So this is an important parameter which helps to determine in which applications the polymer can be used. Later, research can go into how this temperature can be increased to suit the application. The second use of the TGA is to help quantify the chemical profile of the polymer. As the polymer is subjected to different temperatures, various components of the polymer degrade at different levels. For example, the moisture content of polymer starts to evaporate at 100 degrees C, which is shown by the weight loss in this range. Similarly, the polymer itself, depending on the type, can degrade between 300 to 500 degrees C. In critical industries like food and pharma, the TGA can be used as a really effective technique to find the purity of the sample. For example, at the end of the TGA curves, after the degradation of the polymer itself, any other presence of additives or filler can be seen, which helps to determine the final purity of the sample in hand. And finally, the TGA can be also used to study the degradation kinetics. By subjecting the polymer to different heating rates, the order of degradation as well as the activation energy can be obtained. Since this is a specialized topic, we will not be able to go too deep into the subject in this video. The TGA experiment is a very slow process. It takes a few hours to get your results, depending on your heating rate. It is worthwhile to note that TGA is not a standalone technique. It is often used along with complementary techniques like DAC and FTIR. Now let's have a look at how they are used together. For example, DAC, or differential scanning calorimeter, measures the enthalpy as a function of temperature. So this is used to identify any thermal events that are happening, for example, crystallization, melting, and so on. How this is being used in conjunction with TGA is when the TGA degradation of two polymers coincide, it'll be really hard to quantify or find out the differences. In this case, DAC in the form of melting peaks can help to identify what these polymers are. Some of the TGA instruments are coupled with what is called FTIR, or Fourier Transform Infrared Spectroscopy. As the polymer is heated and the gas evolves from the polymer, these are fed through a tube into the FTIR, and this helps to identify the type of volatiles or additives that are added onto the polymer. Polyethylene is a widely used polymer known for its excellent thermal stability. The TGA curve for polyethylene exhibits a gradual weight loss starting around 300 to 400 degrees C due to its thermal decomposition. The onset temperature or weight loss can be an indicator of the polymer's degradation temperature, and the slope of the curve provides insights into the degradation kinetics. This information helps us understand the thermal stability of the polyethylene and design more heat-resistant variants for specific applications. In this particular case of polyethylene study, we also see a small weight loss between 0 to 100 degrees C, which could be due to the presence of additives that are added to improve its strength. So the first precautions you need to take is that the sample quantity should be close enough to represent the entire sample size. Be cautious on the type of pans that are being used. For example, choose a pan which can be stable at the temperature range that is being used for the experiment, as well as not reacting with the sample. Always ensure that the pans are clean and are calibrated before running the experiment. Residues from previous experiments can play a part in your TGA curves in the current one. Over a period of time, the electronics of the TGA start to drift, so always ensure that you have a calibration standard to make sure that your temperature and your weight are accurate. Your TGA instrument is highly sensitive. Even placing your hand on the table can cause your TGA curves to drift. And that is it for this video. If you enjoyed learning about TGA and got any value out of this, do like and subscribe. Leave a comment if you have any questions on TGA curves. And if you'd like to know more about different kinds of testing that is used in polymers, metals, plastics, rubber testing, and so on. See you then.